We talked a little bit about this on Saturday night, but more information has come out that seems to show that Target is going after their customers now, and it's a little weird how this is happening. Y'all need to check this out. Oh, and by the way, that little commercial at the very beginning of this actually comes from Newsweek's article about this. I didn't add the music. They did. Target boycott over LGBTQ plus products is literally terrorism, says an economist. This is written by Fatma Khaled, whatever. Backlash and calls from conservatives to boycott Target over Pride Month themed products, including reported threats to store employees, is literally terrorism, an economist said on Thursday. Stop for a second. Hold up. We'll stop on that right there. You have yet to provide any threats from anybody that would be conservative or any way as to this claim. You have yet to provide that information. The only thing that I have ever seen is people recording employees and asking them, do you agree with this? That's the only thing that has ever come up. However, there have been threats from these crazy ideologues, and we'll get into that a little bit here, but let's continue a little bit. Target was prompted to remove its Pride-themed products after threats were reportedly made to store employees in the midst of anti-LGBTQ plus backlash. The retailer will be pulling the items at the center of a most significant controversial behavior from customers, Kayla Canestetta, a Target spokesperson, said on Tuesday. The decision to pull the products from some stores in the South comes from just days before the beginning of Pride Month in June. It always comes after the recent calls from conservatives to boycott the beer brand Bud Light from its partnership with transgender influencer and activist Dylan Mulvaney. A Target spokesperson told Insider on Thursday that removing the Pride products was a response to threats impacting our team members' sense of safety and well-being. Justin Wolfers, a professor of public policy and economics in the University of Michigan, said in the 11th hour on MSNBC that he finds the response from Target quite scary. Again, you have never shown any kind of proof whatsoever other than videos of people asking Target employees if they agree with this of any kind of threats to safety and well-being. However, I'm about to show you proof that it's not coming from conservatives. Y'all need to check this part out. Utah Target evacuated after it received a bomb threat for turning its back on LGBT community after Pride Collection walked back. Store is one of the several to receive this threat. A Utah Target has been evacuated and a bomb squad has been called in after multiple threats were made against the store across the state and five in Ohio after the company's annual Pride Collection sparked fury. Leighton Target, located at 810 West 2000 North, was evacuated after receiving multiple bomb threats. Bomb squad and a K-9 unit were deployed to the store around 1 p.m., according to KUTV. All staff and customers were directed to the parking lot. Police say stores in Leighton, Sauk Lake, Taylorsville, and Provo were threatened. Authorities became aware of the threats after local news stations received emails threatening danger and referencing the company's new controversial Pride collection. Five targets in across Northeast Ohio and Pennsylvania were also threatened, according to Cleveland 19, who received a threatening email list stores to Stowe, North Canton, Boardman, Niles, Ohio, Monaco, and Pennsylvania. Target is full of, redacted, cowards who turned their back on the LGBT community and decided to cater to homophobic, right-wing, redneck bigots who protested and vandalized their store. There is no proof of vandalization in any way other than people tearing down a sign and stomping on it that was from years ago. The email to Cleveland 19 read, "We won't stand idly by as the far right continues to hunt us down. We are sending you a message. We placed a bomb in the following targets." The email continued. "We will continue to bomb your targets until you stop cowering and bring back your LGBT merchandise. We will not be erased. We will not go quietly." Cleveland 19 reported the threatening email to all local police offices and the FBI. Layton Police Sergeant John Austin told KUTV that the threats made in Utah came from a bogus email address. Target announced earlier this week that some products would be removed from their Pride collection. So you're going to sit there and tell me that you're going to make threats to these businesses that removed your items because people stopped buying from them? That it's terrorism, because we're not propping up this stuff with our hard-earned dollars while you sit back living off the government calling us terrorists. None of this makes any sense. It's all completely stupid. All the violence is coming from one side, yet everybody else is being blamed for it. Nah, it's time to stop this madness. You best start arresting these people, and you best start prosecuting these people, because there is about to be a huge problem in this country if the law only swings one way. And it's not going to be good. But let me know what y'all think about this in the comments section here. Let's get this information out there and let's start telling people the actual real truth about this, so that these deranged lunatics can no longer get their way and they can stop blaming us for what they're doing.